Can you say life on two wheels?
Who can really say? What's up, guys? It is Friday, Black Friday, and it's about 5 in the morning, and we are on our way to Day in the Dirt. Got everything loaded up. Bike's looking good. Got firewood, boots, gear. Truck's full, bike's full. Let's get to Glen Helen. All right, we made it. Day in the Dirt helmet looks good. Vars ready, definitely not hungover. Bike's still dirty. What is this? Whiteout. Our hitch hotel has arrived for the weekend. Gonna get it all parked and pulled out. So you guys can see how small this thing is collapsed when you're towing. It's literally like 45 inches, I think, and then this flips up. All right, we're gonna set up and probably gonna take about a minute and a half, so I'm just gonna snap my fingers and it'll be all good.
Only $200.
Wow.
With a pump on it. So
it has a pump on it?
Yeah. So what it is, it's a mattress that's memory foam, but
life is rough.
You can fill it up with air.
What the heck?
I'm gnarly.
They're gonna custom make them for us.
Yeah.
How you doing, man? Thank you.
Oh, he's got a light, it's a pump.
What?
How's that little thing doing?
Right now, it's filling itself because it's vacuum.
What?
If you want to make it fill fast.
Wow.
Do you see it?
Some fancy shit.
It is just the sickest thing. And it's obviously not the right width, but we need to sell a bunch of them before they're going to private label. But it'll be private label hitch or two.
Wow. First in-person look at the new Day in the Dirt Bellmoto 10. Looks sweet. Lots of pearls. Red carbon, the gold. This might be my new favorite Day in the Dirt helmet ever. Thing turned out sweet. Mr. Villopoto.
Yes, sir.
I'm gonna film. I noticed your, there's a new logo.
Yeah, Fast House, bro.
Is this the debut?
Debut here at, what is this, 2024, I guess, yeah? 23, yeah.
I think,
not
yet.
Day in the Dirt. I've never done Day in the Dirt. Obviously, I've seen all the footage, all the hype up around it. So it's our first year. Came on with Fast House. Well, this is the debut, but probably, I don't know, 3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And went up and met with Kenny and have had, we had lunch together, checked out their whole, you know, the warehouse, store and all that. And we hit it off right away. I think we have like-minded way. I said, dude, your slogans, we race sometimes, and that's me. I probably really race, I don't know, once or twice a year now. So, but I love coming out and hanging out and doing these things with the gig that we have with Yamaha and Blue Crew. We do a lot of that now. So it really fits our program really well. The boys want to kind of start racing too. So this is their...
They're kitted up already too.
Yeah, they're kitted up. So yeah, it's been a blast. So I'm glad to be part of the family.
Yeah, it's a great fit. Lastly, why 2VDF?
Because dude, I'm not good enough to ride a 450 anymore. They're too fast.
You know, Air Ray just said that to me today too.
Yeah, well, all these guys are not. I'm the first one. I've started a trend, I think.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
I'm a trendsetter. Is where it comes into play is I'm like, I traded in the 450. I still have the 450. It's at PC, but I'm like, look, Mike. I'm like, I need a 250F. I can ride 5 or 6 laps and actually feel pretty good.
Yeah.
Instead of blowing my arms out right away on a 450, I don't ride enough. And I can ride that to the ability that I feel is still pretty fast, but also safe. Getting on a 450, it's a whole different ballgame.
Yeah.
It's heavier. It's a lot faster. You really got to kind of, you know, kind of be in shape to ride one. So I said, look, I'll ride the new YZ250F is amazing. So. It's got plenty enough power for me.
Uh-huh.
Turns super well, and I'm like, dude, I can get 5, 6, 7 laps depending on the track. And so yeah, that's what I'm riding now. I'm a 250F guy. I'm back.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Already?
Are you worried about being teammates with A-Ray?
I'm a little worried for him.
You're not sharing the same bike, right?
No.
Okay, you're good.
No, we'll be good.
Yeah.
We're just going to be ripping.
You know, like...
Dude, the off-road guys are fast.
You know, like, when was this? Probably 6 months ago at Paris. You were right. Oh, maybe it was the Maxis ride day.
Yeah, it was the Maxis.
You were doing
ride.
Motos, and Aries like, who the fuck is that going so fast? He was so pissed.
And then we got to the Nationals, and he was like 8 seconds faster.
You know, hey, you got to bring your A game on race day. You don't get paid for practice days.
All right, day in the door practice. Practice is done.
Done and dusted.
Aries got a burger.
Hell
tired
yeah.
Life.
Hey, already slammed a beer. Already good. Dude, hey. This is so much more fun than like actually racing dirt bikes. Like,
yeah, are you saying this is more fun than A1?
Are you kidding me? Yeah. Yeah, the track is actually really rough though. I don't know. Ask me that question
after
Sunday.
Coup de Gras?
After Coup de Gras. Yeah. So like, I don't know, man. I built a great bike coming here this weekend. Here to have fun. That's all that matters.
I think just now is the first time I've ever walked up to you during a race day and seen you smiling.
Oh, dude, I'm usually shitting my pants. I'm usually in the porta potty or like doing something of that sort, right? So, all right,
500 update real quick.
It bogged coming down the hill. I don't know. I don't know. The thing's fast though. Holy shit.
All right, and if anyone has a YZ2 VDF and wants to trade A-Ray for a 4 VDF?
Hey, if you have a newer style, either 2023, 2024...
No, 24 is the new one. For 2VD.
Oh, yeah. I need a 2024. If anybody is willing to trade, it's like, this 24 is like, it's too slow, and wants a 450, holler at me, because I will trade straight up my 450 for a 2VDF. I'm not a 450 guy anymore, dude.
Nope.
No, I'm a desk guy.
All right.
Track's rough as shit.
It's very rough.
Oh my god.
Alright, so as you saw in the GoPro, got a little whiskey dick in the asphalt, of course, of all places, and laid it over. Gonna need a new grip. That'll make it for the rest of the weekend.
Did you show the elbow?
No, not yet. Yeah. Nice.
Oh, you have a good camera on this thing. It's like, you leave that out.
Let's see. What else? What else did we do?
Show the pipe?
Yosh pipe got a little shine, a little buff. Frame also got a buffing. Should come off with some Scotch-Brite. Peg's good, somehow. Lever. We're good. We're good. Shroud's a little bad, but actually, shroud's really good. So, all said and done, not bad.
That's Clade Kaysen right
Clade
there.
Kaysen.
Clade Kaysen.
Clade Kaysen. What?
He's barking, dude. Bark.
Are there any parts you don't want me to highlight on the build? Like any parts you're not happy about? Because it looks pretty dialed.
Really happy about everything.
Are those stock hubs just Cerakoted?
Yeah. Stock hubs Cerakoted. This is a 2020 front end or front.
W.
Front wheel, and then the stock ones on the back. Stock. KX500. I reused the hub. Just laced it up. John Anderson and W. Took care of me with the wheels and bro, I'm just stoked on everything. Gut seat cover, guts tall foam, Maxxis tires, I got the Dockwob axle, Dockwob reservoir and nut right here for the pivot bolt, and then also like this cover. JSV pipe from Belgium. So I actually had to get my frame welded down here, so I didn't have time because I ran out of time to drill a hole to put the top pipe mount on here.
I see.
So I mean, we got a little bit of rubbish, but
it's fine.
We have one right here. That's fine. Race Tech shock. I'm gonna be honest with you. The suspension out there, it was plush. I didn't bottom this thing once. It was amazing.
Wow.
Jason over at TRE, the guys over at TRE, the Racer's Edge in Simi Valley, went through the whole engine. I had to get a new crank. I had to get new...
Oh, a fat head.
Yeah, I got a fat head on here, and it's got my name etched in on the other side, which is badass. I had to get a new crank. I had to get a new transmission. I had to get a new, like, shaft for this thing.
Yep,
I got, you know, I got new rear brake, new kickstarter, new shift lever. Hoppa over at, you know, Boyson, our boy Hoppa, he got me the ignition cover on the other side, and then I also got the rad valve for this thing. It's a beast.
All right, how much are you into it?
I don't want to talk about that. I really do not want to talk about that.
I mean, I got this off, I got everything. It's hard to find parts of these things, so I had to get a lot of stuff off eBay. You know, I had to reuse some of the parts. Justin at Moto Whips helped me out with a lot of stuff as well, with like vapor blasting and some powder coating. Like I said, JSV is from Belgium. I got a pipe through them.
How much was that shipping?
It wasn't much. They helped me out like a little bit with that, but it was quite a bit. KX Guru as well. He put me in contact with some people to get some different foot peg mounts, because the foot peg mounts on these things they're a little weak. So I got some different foot peg mounts so I could have some updated foot pegs. I mean, I had to get the frame welded. I had to get the cases welded in a few spots because they were not good. I mean, there's still like a broken piece right here as well. ICW redid the radiators.
The tank, dude. That's everyone's first comment, is the tank.
Yeah.
Where did that come from?
I found it on eBay. It was a guy out of Georgia that had it on there, had it listed, and I jumped on it because it was a little bit cheaper than what I could get them from Europe. So, it was in the U.S., so the shipping wasn't super bad. So, did that. I got an updated front end off eBay, which was super cool. Ran into a little bit of issues with that, but we'll get that ironed out. Yeah, I mean, this thing, it came out way better than I ever imagined.
It's too nice.
It is too nice.
It's by far the best build you've done.
You think?
Oh, 100%. This smokes the other bikes. Thanks.
It's just an iconic bike, right? Like, it's a KX500. Not a lot of people have them. Hard to find parts, you know, and thing rips. And it sounds so crisp, too.
Yeah, it does sound good.
Yeah. And then I also got a carburetor from Sunco.
What was that?
A Kian carburetor from Sunco.
Yep.
I mean, he tuned it up and everything, so it's all good there with that. I don't know if this is like radiator fluid or what. I don't know.
Nah,
it might just be splash, but I don't know. I might take it over there and wash it.
Much later.
All right, guys. So I ventured into basically the equivalent of Lot B for you guys to document some of the chaos.
Oh my God!
Let's see the rock placement. Okay.
This is so
more fuel. Oh. Yep, check the angle.
That's good.
She's sturdy. Oh, more fuel. Alright guys, night one in the hitch hauler. I'm gonna call it a night. It stayed pretty warm in here throughout the day, so I don't even think I'm gonna turn on the heater, but we'll see.
finished up the stunt GP on Saturday. Kind of screwed Dahmer and I because I was watching the wrong guy. Forgot what helmet he was wearing. So off to a rough start. And then I came around and screwed him again and overshot the entry to swap wristbands. Track is gnarly, but it was fun. It was a super good time. Bliss and I are awaiting our beer, batter, pretzel, and our pulled pork sandwich.
Wow. Look at that. Done. Is this cool? You let me know. I don't think so, but maybe you do.
Ha ha ha! Last night was the last night in the Hitch Hotel. How was it, babe? Nice and cozy?
Yeah, it was great.
We had the heater on, a couple of windows open, so it was not too hot because that thing really worked. It was nice. It was perfect. Got to charge our phones.
Later on in the week. So, like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, maybe even into next weekend, we may be getting rain here in Southern California. But no rain expected for us today.
Alright guys, just like that, day in the dirt 2023 is done. Sunday, it's really, really windy, and track's hammered as expected, and I'm not feeling too great, to be honest. So I was pretty lazy in the coup de grace. No, I was pretty lazy in the Moto Go Go race, but we got through it. Everyone left healthy, and yeah, it was a blast. This Hitch Hotel was definitely one of the highlights of my weekend. It made everything so much easier. Got to have my chick with me at the track. Got to stay here and hang out with friends at night. Yeah, super badass. Obviously, I had the power so I could charge my camera equipment, my GoPro, my phone, heater. Yeah, it was just really, really convenient and super, super rad. A lot of people walked up wanting some specs and details on it because thing looks pretty unique. So yeah, stay tuned. I think we're gonna do a little bit more with this thing, so if you're interested, either go look up at hitchhotel.com, their Instagram, or DM me. I know quite a bit about it now already, so yeah, let me know if you're interested.